this is the first 40 years of my life. I really felt that the writing of the book, the telling of the story, was a kind of a process that was really helpful in my own inner healing, and also gave me an opportunity to kind of understand who I was now after becoming a Christian, prior to a life of crime and violence and such a complete opposite. It's just been a transformation. My father left home when I was 18 months old, and I was brought up in a household that was full of love, but at the same time full of a lot of chastisement. And I was beaten with a stick, kept in line by disciplinary, and also abused as a child by a family friend. So by the time I became a teenager, I was a very mixed up little boy. And just before my 15th birthday, I found my mum on the settee. She passed away from a cerebral hemorrhage through the night, and my whole life as I knew it then fell apart. I vowed that day to never be a victim again, and started to get heavily involved in the tough men and the hard men of the pubs and clubs, and it was another 15 years of a revolving door in and out of prison, drug dealing, debt collection, violence, fighting, drinking, womanizing, taking drugs, selling drugs, a fearsome reputation, so hostile, so violent. I was a broken mess in a prison cell, just about to contemplate taking my own life. I asked God for a symbol of a white glove. He provided that symbol. And that very day, I made a conscious choice to accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. From that date, I vowed I would never commit another offence. And I've never been in trouble, I've never been arrested, I've never committed any offence, I've never hit anybody. That man of violence has become a man of love, a caring father, a business owner, director of a charity, and the author of a book. When I was writing the book, I was writing about three quarters of somebody I didn't know anymore, the old Alan. And the people in the community knew that guy. They hated that guy, they feared that guy. And then to the same people to go online, vote for me for the People's Book Prize, to write comments, it reduced me to tears because it's voted for by the people. And to go from being unlisted to shortlisted by those votes from the local community, it's just so humbling. It's just beautiful. It's humbling. I'm so grateful.